In this tutorial, I'm going to give you a quick overview of how to use Qubi. And Qubi is like a really nice way of deploying to Kubernetes clusters without having to go through YAML hell, and I really like it. So we've got our Kubernetes cluster, and we have a managed database all on DigitalOcean. And we're going to use a GitHub action to deploy this. So whenever we push to our main branch, it's just going to go out to Kubernetes. We don't even have to run Docker locally if we don't want to. And the end result is we have a website which is just going to be up, which we can shut into that server. So if I want to run some commands, just ls-al. Yeah, there's our server. All buttons exec rails C. Cool, I can go access the console really easily. So yeah, let's jump in. So to kind of get prepared beforehand, I set up a Kubernetes cluster in DigitalOcean. So this is where we're going to be like running our app from. A container registry, and this is where we're going to be pushing our Docker image to, and a database. And I like to keep my databases outside of Kubernetes, so if I ever want to maybe move my app to a Droplet or something else, it's a bit easier to manage because I just like that. And for this tutorial, we're going to be going through the quick start guide together. I'm not going to be following it exactly, but it is a pretty good guide, and I'm going to deviate from it a little bit. So let's jump in and have some fun. So we're going to be pushing to DigitalOcean. And if I scroll down to the docs, Qubi has a gen or an extension specifically for DigitalOcean. So we're going to add both of these to our gen file. So I'm going to do bundle add Qubi core. Nice. And I'm also going to do bundle add Qubi DigitalOcean. And that's the little extension for us to push to DigitalOcean. Nice. And my next favorite thing is they have a generator. So we're just going to run the generator to help us get started. And I currently have a Docker file, and it's a little bit different from the one provided. If I press the D key and have a little look at what's different, it's not too different. I think mine's fine. I'm just going to say no, keep my current Docker ignore file. So if I go git status now, you can see we've changed our gem file, and we've added these two new Qubi files. So let's have a look at those. So this is the main important file Qubi has generated, and it's pretty fantastic. I like it. And we're going to go through it step by step. So the first thing we're going to start with is these credentials. And it's looking for credentials for our application, and I haven't set them up yet. There's nothing in here, no master key, nothing. So I'm going to go ahead and quickly generate some credentials for this app. And the way I'm going to do that is by running this command here, which is editor, all capitals, equals code wait. So that's going to open VS Code and then bundle exec Rails credentials edit. So when I do that, it's going to do two things. One, it's going to generate this credentials file and open it. And then two, it's going to generate this master key. And this is the key we're going to use to like encrypt this file. So if I was to quickly close this, go back to terminal, it says, okay, we've encrypted that. And if I quickly jump into our credentials file here, it's nice and encrypted. So we can store it in version control and not worry too much. So that's pretty fantastic. So now we can store things like our Docker username or our database URL, that kind of stuff, nice and securely. The next block we're going to look at is configuring Docker. So this is kind of what runs when we run Docker build and we push it somewhere. And DigitalOcean is kind of quirky because the username and password we're going to use to log in with are actually a API token. So I'm going to very quickly go ahead and generate a token in DigitalOcean here. I'm just going to click generate new token, call it Qubi, and then good to go. And there it is. And I'm going to store this securely in our Rails credentials file. So let's quickly go into here. Nice. And I'm going to make it all caps because that's fine. And I'm going to call it digital ocean API token. And there's our token. So quickly copy that. And I'm going to save that as our username and password. So now when it goes to log into Docker, it's going to use our DigitalOcean API token, which is pretty fantastic. The next thing we need to do is set our image URL. And for this, we're going to go to our container registry, and we're going to set this as like the base place we're pushing to. So I'm going to quickly change that. And we're going to change the image name from my project to be called sample-app. So this means when we go to push our image, it's going to push up and appear in here, which is very lovely. So now is the really exciting bit. We're going to be configuring our Kubernetes cluster, which is going to be really fun. And there's not too much to this. Kube offers a bunch of plugins we just smash in here. So they've got one for like the Rails app, one for Sidekick. Very much enough to kind of get you going. And you kind of put some credentials in, and then you get an app which works, which is pretty fantastic. So I'm going to start by setting my host name. So this is going to be the domain where we want our app to like kind of be visible to. This, I'm going to show you this at the end, but pretty much it will set up a TLS certificate so we can have HTTPS, just sorted out the box. The next thing we're going to do is say manage database, manage service, manage database FOSS, because we don't actually want Kube to manage our database in this case. We've got one set up in here, and we're going to just link to that. So how are we going to link to this? Well, we're going to pass it an environmental variable. So we're going to make a block, which is envdo, and we're going to say data do, and add, I think it's database URL. Database rules. No, it's database URL, and we're going to be storing this database URL in the app creds. So just like that. Okay, let's go ahead and quickly set our database URL so it will be available to our application when we put it online. So I'm going to go in here, got our database URL, and what I'm going to do is go to DigitalOcean and go to the database section where I've set one up already. And I'm going to quickly say, give us a connection string. And I'm going to step, that's a script. I've set up a database called app production already. And I'm just going to copy this in. So this is the username, the password, the URL, the port, the database name, all that. I just put it straight into here. And that's going to be passed to our Docker image when it runs on Kubernetes. So it will know where to find the database. Kind of a bit like Heroku. It's very nifty. Let's jump down to this provider section. So this is telling Kube who actually, you know, provides our Kubernetes cluster. And in our case, it's going to be DigitalOcean. So we can get rid of this lovely comment and open a little block here. So let's configure this. So we're going to start off with an access token. And yep, that's correct. We're going to pass in our API token from above. That's going to be used to chat to our Kubernetes cluster and set everything up. And the next thing we're going to do is a cluster ID. And for this, we need to go into DigitalOcean and quickly find it. So there's my Kubernetes cluster. It has a tag there, but the way to find the actual cluster ID is in the URL bar up here. So if I was just to quickly copy that and smash that in here. Cool, that's all ready. So this looks pretty good, but I think DigitalOcean should probably be one word to match that. Just in this little app cred. So I'm going to quickly go ahead and just update that and quickly edit the credentials to match that as well. So, yep, close that, save that, and that's all done. Cool. Okay, I think it's time to configure our cluster now. So right now we have our little Kubernetes cluster here. It's not had any configuration done at all, so very empty. And if I go down to networking, there's nothing in here at all. So I'm going to go ahead and run bundle exec kubi dash e production. So e dash e production because this environment is production. And I'm just going to say setup. And let's see what it does. Cool. Okay. So something's happened. And if we go to here, we've got some colors going on, which is pretty exciting. And if we go to our networking page here, it's created a load balancer. So the load balancer is going to have an IP address, and we're going to point our domain from here to that IP address. So our load balancer is all provisioned, which is fantastic, and we have a nice IP address for it. So if I was to visit this IP address now, it currently 404s, and I've also pointed this domain to point to that IP address. Right now, it doesn't work because, surprise, surprise, there's nothing there. It won't accept connections. So we're going to now deploy our app. And to make it really easy on ourselves, I've set up a GitHub Action for us. And it's going to run through these steps. So the build, the push, and it's going to skip the setup because we've already done that. And it's going to run this deploy step. So how does this work? Well, whenever we push to our main branch, it'll just go through all the things such as like logging into DigitalOcean, running the build, and pushing it out and deploying it, which is very exciting. We do have to do some quick configuration though, which is kind of irritating. The first thing we're going to do is add secrets to our GitHub repository. So I'm going to go ahead and do that now quickly. I'm going to add the DigitalOcean access token and the Rails master key. So here's my repository. I'm going to go settings, actions, and oh, even better, secrets. That's where I meant to go. And so, yep, digital access token. And we're going to grab that from our credentials here. Cool. That looks about right. And the other one is the Rails master key, which is this one here. For some reason, I find it really hard to copy and paste. Oops, visual to do that. Nope, I'm just gonna try and copy and paste harder. There we go, perfect. Okay, cool. And where do you find your Rails master key? In my case, it's in the master.key file under the configuration folder. It might be a bit different for you. It might be stored in an environmental variable or something already. But as long as that's in there, it's all good. Cool. So let's cancel that. Let's do adding deploy GitHub action. And we're going to push this up. So now when we go to actions, you can see it's now running. So it's going to go through all the steps. Please load this up. It'll take a minute to get going. So it's going to go through all the steps. There we go. It's going to go through all the steps. And it'll take about 10 minutes to run the first time, but it should push out our app to DigitalOcean. And every time we run subsequent like pushes to the main branch, it'll just deploy that straight out. Cool, so this is just finished. And it took 11 minutes in total. I think it could be a little bit quicker. There was because it was the first time it ran, it hasn't cached all the like Docker layers and a few of the other things. That's fine. And if we go to our container registry, we can see We now have some stuff pushed up, which is quite exciting, which our Kubernetes cluster has put down. So if you go to our cluster here, you can see we have some quite exciting stuff going on here, like some pods are running web stuff. It's all kind of meaningless to me, but something's happened here. But the key thing is, if we go to our website now, it's up, which is very exciting, and I can actually add a sample post. So that's very cool. And if I was to quickly go to terminal, I can actually shell into this machine. So there we go. There's our little app we've pushed up there. And if I was to go bundle exec Rails C to access the Rails console, and if we did post.last.update title to be hello world. Cool, that's very successfully updated. So that's pretty fantastic. That's kind of Kubi in a very short demo, and I really encourage you to have a good look at it and play with it. It's kind of a fun way of deploying to DigitalOcean, especially when you have this nice little GitHub action just to push stuff out when it hits main. And I'm gonna have this all open source once this comes out, so you can have a nice look at the code. And yeah, thank you so much for watching this. Please remember to like, comment, and subscribe, and give me a follow on Twitter, and share this with whoever you know. It's always appreciated. And I'll see you next time. Thank you. Cheers. Bye.